So I think the question about Casemiro is interesting for the second leg because obviously that's going to be something a bit of a hot topic, especially with Real Madrid's depth chart being very thin right now. So Casemiro is a huge absence in a way that like he's been so good defensively. Like he's always been good defensively. I feel like he's gone up another level in the last couple of years defensively, even for his standards. And he's been so good at covering for both of Real Madrid's fullbacks, but also he's been good at, as a presser. He has been important offensively too. I mean, and that's either good or bad, but he's been important offensively. There is a part of me that like sometimes just gets ex I don't know if excited is the right word, but at least I look at it with intrigue if he's not playing to see because I tend to enjoy when Real Madrid have a lot of capable ball carriers and creators in midfield to control things. And there's a part of me also that thinks Atalanta is just going to go, they're going to just press a lot more in the second leg, which means that Casemiro will be a lot of under a lot of pressure in that game. And just given that, I actually don't. If you have Fede there, because to me the lineup kind of picks this up, because I think Fede is going to be back by then, and you might see something like Fede, Modric, Kroos, and Isco, because Isco's a talking point right now, obviously. So I don't think Isco disappears for the second leg. So I think if you have a midfield quartet of that, you have a good chance of being press resistant, but also keeping possession, and your ball progression is pretty good. So in that sense, I'm not entirely worried about it. I actually think that it can work just fine without him.
Yeah, because at the same time, you should assume that Benzema will be back at least for the match against Atletico. So at the same time, that midfield quartet will allow you to play with this 4-4-2 formation again, because Benzema is a more pure attacker than the ones Real Madrid had yesterday. So the recoveries for Valverde and Benzema are definitely crucial in for this couple of weeks. Those two players should be accounted for, because the roles and their importance within the team, now that Casemiro won't be available for the return leg, is going to be very important.
Yeah, it also I think in some ways depends on obviously how Zidane uses it. I remember that I think it was 2018 against Bayern when Casemiro missed a second leg and Kovacic played as a defensive midfielder, and that was a disaster. They were just getting carved, and but part of the reason was that because Kovacic played the anchor role by himself and he's not really used to that. So I think if you have just a double pivot with maybe Fede and Modric and double pivot with Kroos a little bit higher, I think that's probably the best way to make it work.
Yeah, I agree.
Our patron Peter says, "How would you rank our nine currently injured players in terms of imminent necessity on the pitch, considering what Real Madrid are showing? My list is number one."